the zone from the bench. Andrew Shaw hands it off to Saad. Saad with a shot through traffic, blocked in front. And Petrangelo able to muscle it out to center right. Here's Tarasenko. He's got off going for the net. Tarasenko shot, he scores! Number 91 comes up huge again for St. Louis. They have grabbed the lead here in game four.
Tarasenko just has the magic touch. After a decent scoring chance for Chicago, which was blocked by Petrangelo right there, the quick up catches Chicago on the press. Tarasenko with a two-on-one. I don't know if that got deflected on the shot, but Tarasenko finds the back of the net. He's a left-hand shot on the right-wing side. Crawford maybe playing for the pass because it was a two-on-one. You see Tarasenko's eyes were looking into the middle. Was he going to pass? Well, he wasn't. And he just quickly fired it on the short side. Caught Crawford leaning off that near side post. Second goal of the night. Tarasenko, magic touch.
Well, this series started with so many lineup question marks for St. Louis, and Tarasenko was one of the guys we really didn't figure would be ready for game one when that cast came off his hand. And then he was ready to go, and already, as you pointed out, Brian, in such good shape with all the skating he had done.
And he hurt that hand again in game one, so that made it seem like it was iffy again, too. But he hasn't blinked since. What a difference he's made in their offense.
Now Steen, he fakes, waits, now lets it go, and Crawford steers to the side. Boy, we've seen two-goal leads evaporate around the league in these playoffs. It's been unbelievable. As the puck started to bounce toward the St. Louis net, and Ryan Miller stayed right there to play it. Petrangelo gets the only assist.
Well, Chicago was pressing up because they knew they hadn't had many scoring chances and been in their own end so much. When Petrangelo blocked that pass, that shot in front of the net and made the quick up, that really caught Chicago.
Now Schwartz sends it in deep.